Now, diesel prices are up by a whole rupee per litre since the 15th of August. And in just the last 4 days alone, diesel prices have skyrocketed by about 60 paise per litre. That's made commuting a challenge. Inflation is on the rise in rural India, particularly where agriculture is heavily dependent on diesel. A rise in prices has had an immediate and sharp impact on transport costs. Well, joining us on our discussion tonight, we're going to have, there you have it, the prices of petrol today in Delhi, 78 rupees, 18 paise a litre, in Kolkata touching 81, in Mumbai, which has always been the highest, it's over 85 rupees a litre, petrol tune at their highest right now. And of course, the big problem, the fact that taxes are more than the base price of fuel itself. Look at that, look at that calculation. If the base price of petrol is 38 rupees a litre, central taxes, state taxes and dealer commissions all add up to that whopping final figure that you see, which is actually higher than the base price itself.
This increase in oil prices in Brent and Dubai crude is really temporary. That's what we've seen, this fluctuations coming in. It should be temporary. It's coming out of some countries not able to produce. So I hope that remains temporary and we will be back to the level of 70, 71 soon.
So that was the Secretary of Economic Affairs today saying that this is temporary. We're hoping prices will stabilize. We hope the rupee will improve, essentially indicating that the government is doing absolutely nothing about that hike in fuel prices. Joining us tonight, Raghav Awasthi, RSS member and lawyer, Gaurav Vallabh, spokesperson with the Congress, is with us. Now, global crude prices, Gaurav, are actually way below their all-time high, and yet petrol and diesel prices in India are at their highest yet. This is a record high. Now, why is the government so resistant to doing absolutely anything to reduce this burden on the middle classes? And is this going to politically backfire?
See, there are three components as far as the oil price is concerned. First is the crude price.
Yes.
Crude price is giving effect because dollar to rupee is at all-time low.
Right.
So we have to pay in dollar terms, and already we touched 70.6 mark. So we that amount is going to increase every day. Second is the Government of India's excise duty. In last 4 years, Government of India had increased excise duty 12 times. And excise duty on diesel increased by 450% and on petrol around 250%. So that is the second component.
Right.
And third is the state VAT. I will give you few data just to understand the thing in a broader perspective. Diesel, as far as diesel is concerned, the all state government, diesel and petrol is concerned, all state governments put together collects 1.8 lakh crore per year in the form of state VAT.
Right.
Whereas Government of India collects in the form of excise duty on petrol and diesel 3 lakh crore. In last 4 years, 11 lakh crore was additionally collected, and it's something like a low hanging fruit because government is not having the manufacturing from where they can collect GST. Service sector is not doing well. The financial service sector is not doing well. Agriculture is at all time low. So only way to sustain itself, it says something that impose excise duty on petrol and diesel. But most dangerous thing is that diesel is at all time high in India.
Right.
And diesel is something which affects common masses.
Yes.
Diesel is something which affects farmers. And you will say that we are giving MSP. But the impact of today's diesel price, the farmer is going to get in the form of MSP after 1.5 years. So
right.
For 1.5 years, how he is going to sustain? So my sincere request to Government of India is that Reserve Bank of India is having a good amount of forex reserves. They should take the short-term perspective into consideration, and by taking that forex reserves into consideration, at least dollar rupee the appreciation can be stopped, and excise duty on diesel should be reduced at least by 10 rupee a litre.
Fair point. And Raghav Awasthi, the Reserve Bank of India has actually said that oil prices are the biggest risk to inflation this year. Now, politically, is this not a worry for the government?
See, as far as the politics of it is concerned, I think we should be loath to take political advice from a party that has lost 30 straight elections at last count. How many, sir? So I don't think we should take them
but
too
why
seriously.
Is the, okay, fair enough.
Having
why
said
is
that,
the
having said
so
that,
adamant
me,
on no. intervening on fuel prices.
No, as far as fuel prices are concerned, I'm not a trained economist, and I will just put this out now. Having said that, there are factors that affect oil that affect crude prices and also the value of the rupee vis-a-vis the dollar that have nothing to do with the trade relation between the India and the United States. You know, so. That can obviously happen. There is obviously a concern that the benefits this burden is having to be borne by the common man, and I'm sure the government will take expeditious steps to ensure that this situation
Except we
improves.
Heard the Secretary of Economic Affairs say that and, you know, we're hoping the situation improves. Essentially,
no, the
appearing
situation,
to say
the
that
situation
you know, nothing,
will
is, nothing is going to be
proactively. No, I'm sure that the government will do something proactively. But I don't think there is any need to take advice as to how to improve the BJP's political prospects from the Congress, because I think the Congress is a party that has elevated
problem
losing elections
that.
And notching
problem
up moral victories to a finer.
I will let you know. Problem is that if every action you will try to link up with the winning or losing, the governance takes the back seat. And precisely that is happening with the current government.
Yes, it's very
so problem is that
that's why
in demonetization, they lost everything. Country had lost 1 crore employment opportunities. Still they are saying it's a great thing. No black money
this
is achieved. Still they are saying it's great thing. Now they are saying petrol prices. We are speaking. We are winning. It's winning and losing is not a priority. Governance is something else. Governance is something else.
Gentlemen, let's bring this back to fuel prices. India is the only country in the world that imposes an over 123% tax on the price of diesel.
And this is not something that has come about only after the BJP came to power.
Let me answer.
Yes.
When in 2014, the excise duty on petrol was 10 rupee. Today it is 20 rupee. In 2014, the excise duty on diesel was 4 rupee a liter. Today it is 14 rupee. And now you are saying this is not something which is not,
no,
not in the past.
All of these
See, please try to understand you failed miserably as far as economic governance
as
is concerned. And now you are saying that we are winning.
If
so we will dictate.
If the BJP
that is not the way of governance.
If
you, are, if you had failed,
the
try to take the advice
the
of the
hustings.
Right people.
The people
if
will
somebody is trained in economics,
the
take the advice. We all are here
BJP,
for the country.
The BJP
we all are here for the country or not? I'm asking
taking
you.
Advice from a
we,
lot of trained economists.
We all
Having
here are for
that,
country or not?
There is no need.
So
there
why
is no
why
need
you
to
are
take any
why
advice
you feel
whatsoever
that I can't
from
take advice
okay,
from
you don't want
who's
to take
Prime Minister and the Indian economy to the ground.
Raghav Awasthi, you don't want to take advice from the Congress, understandably, but you know, is it or is it not true that wholesale prices have risen at the fastest pace in 2.5 years as fuel prices are climbing? And is inflation not a concern?
Well, I think as far as inflation is concerned, as far as consumer price inflation is concerned, I don't have the latest figures right now. But I think the rate of increase in inflation, I mean, as far as that marker is concerned, this government compares favorably to the previous government. So these people don't have much of a locus to speak.
Because you had not pointed out.
If there was no runaway inflation, then they would not have been reduced to 48 seats or whatever
Raghav,
they.
Okay, I'm going to have to take last
just,
comments.
Just last
this,
comment,
yes.
Raghav. The consumer price inflation is right now 5%. It is increasing day by day. And why it was not high? Let me complete. Why it was not high in the first 2-3 years? Because crude prices were at $25-$30 per barrel. So don't take the advantage. It's good. As an Indian, I am happy with that. But don't say
I'm
that
glad.
We had done miserably good. You had
you
not
are.
Done at all.
I'm
it's only external
are
factors are helping you. And
now
when the tough time arrives, you are leaving. You are saying that we can't control.
There are Naxals whom you've jailed. Now you want to take their support to win elections. I'm glad that you're happy that something good is happening.
There are those who say that those arrests come at a time when perhaps, you know, certain people don't want fuel prices to be discussed.
They don't want to discuss agriculture. They don't want to discuss employment. They don't want to discuss inflation. They don't want to discuss the high interest rate. They want to discuss only urban Naxal, semi-urban Naxal, village Naxal. We are fed up with
this. Neither of you can be heard.
Please deliver governance.
Neither of you can be heard. I'm going to wrap this up right now. I have to. And the fuel price hike has clearly had a direct impact on the cost of transportation, not just for the common man, but the inflationary impact on the price of household goods is likely to have a far more wide-ranging influence. We're only going to be talking about this further in the days to come, unless prices head southwards soon or the government indeed has a change of heart.